This is Thailand's high-speed rail network, and it is one of Southeast Asia's biggest projects ever. This massive infrastructure plan is set to be operational by 2025 and is expected to cost a whopping $6 billion just for its Phase 1. The total cost of this entire plan is estimated to be well over $55 billion, and its last phase of construction will end by 2037. And at this stage, entire Thailand will be surrounded by high-speed rail. A total of 2,654 kilometers of the track will be covered. This will make Thailand one of the best countries in Asia to travel to when they actually achieve this magnificent project. Imagine that you can go around the entire country in just one day, which will boost Thailand's tourism economy by a whole new level. The first phase of the construction, which is set to be fully operational by 2025, is called the Northeastern HSR, which will cover Bang Su all the way to Nong Khai, which will have a total length of over 873 kilometers long. It is expected to be partly operational by 2023, which will cover the first few stations. The proposed rolling stock that will be used here is called the CRRC Foxing Series EMU, a train that has an operating speed of 250 kilometers per hour and has a maximum speed of over 300 kilometers per hour. What's more is that it has a capacity of over 1,300 people. The contractor of this mega project is divided into 14 contracts, whereas both Chinese firms and local Thailand firms will join to construct the railway. Thailand's high-speed rail will have 8 routes, the first of which we discussed will start from Bang Su all the way to Nong Khai. The second route, which is named the Eastern HSR, will start from Don Mueang all the way to U-Tapao. This route is designated to connect 3 airports and surrounding areas, but more specifically, to help navigate an airport-to-airport travel. This phase is estimated to finish at 2030. The third and fourth routes will expand the Northeastern and Eastern HSR phase and will finish in 2029 and 2033. The next 4 phases will come at a later date. These will be called the Northern HSR and Southern HSR. The Northern HSR will start from Bang Su all the way to Hua Hin, while the Southern HSR will start from Bang Su to Padang Besar. And all of these are expected to be fully operational by 2037. Quite an exciting time to be alive. While the project seems and sounds futuristic, it was in fact already approved way back a decade ago in the year 2010. It was even scheduled to be operational by 2018. However, setbacks have happened because of several political crises involving parliament problems and the military coup that happened in 2014. After the problems, however, they are now back on track, but with the recent challenges that have occurred, they may be pushed way back to the future. Such an expensive project will in no doubt help Thailand's economy. Several studies have found that because of Thailand's strong tourism economy, it is expected that this will give an internal rate of return of 13% from its investment of over $55 billion. Data has shown that Thailand is one of the world's most touristic places. A high-speed rail like this will help increase the flow of tourists coming in every year. People around the world would want to visit Thailand a lot more in the future. This entire project will be connected to the Kunming-Singapore Railway, which will connect China to the entire Southeast Asia region. This will also utilize the new Bang Su Grand Station, as it is the first phase of the construction. What's more surprising is that Bang Su Grand Station, at the time of this writing, is already complete, and Bang Su Grand Station is officially the largest railway station in the entire Southeast Asia, which makes Thailand slowly coming up on the ladder of good economic growth. The problem with such an extensive project is that even though there are several studies that show how efficiently it will help the country, it still does not mean that the studies done are certain. There are also studies that showed that the projected daily ridership would not even be reached. Once it is open, it is said to have at least 30,000 to 50,000 daily riders, but the State Railway of Thailand, or SRT, cited it might just be around 10,000. Anyway, what do you think about the new high-speed rail in Thailand? Share with us your thoughts in the comments below. Don't forget to leave us a like and follow us for more amazing videos in the future. Thanks for watching!